Hello, Islander. You've decided to explore the research question, what impact do oil spills have on ocean life? If you haven't done so yet, pause the video here and take a moment to brainstorm some important keywords or phrases you can use to explore this question further. Don't forget to look at the question for some initial keywords and to use synonyms of those words as well. On the screen, you can see some of the keywords or phrases that I was able to brainstorm as I did the same exercise. The first key phrase I focused on was oil spills. I identified another similar keyword as oil and also the key phrase oil industry. I then focused on the phrase ocean life. Similarly, I could also use ocean, marine life, and fish as possible keywords to search. This list is not exhaustive, but it's a good start as we begin the research process. Do you see any similarities or differences between our lists? Our different experiences with these topics may mean we use different words to search for information. Similarly, those who write and create content around this topic may use different words as well. This list is by no means final. As we begin the search process, we're going to find new words that we might not have thought about before, and then we can add those to our list. But now that we've decided on what words we will use to begin our search, the next steps in developing our search strategy is deciding where to search. We can determine where to search by knowing what types of resources we want to look at. Different formats of information give us different perspectives, and different search engines lend themselves better to specific formats of information. To help us better understand where to search, let's start by familiarizing ourselves with the information timeline. The information timeline is the process in which information changes over time. Typically, an event happens, and then the information timeline begins. The steps in the timeline include social media, news, magazines and blogs, scholarly and peer-reviewed journal articles, and books. Let us use an example of an oil spill to walk through the timeline. On April 20, 2010, the Deepwater Horizon oil rig caught fire and sank in the Gulf of Mexico, eventually becoming the biggest oceanic oil spill in history. Within a day of the incident, we could begin to see people posting about the tragedy on social media. Also within the first 24 hours, news reporters and journalists began to inform the public about the event. Then after a week or so, we began to see magazine articles and blogs about the event. Magazines and blogs, while different formats of information, both take the information from journalistic reporting and expand upon it, interpreting the information and framing it in a way different from news journalists. Then after a few months, scholarly and peer-reviewed journal articles start to appear. The peer-reviewed process takes months because articles published in this format are reviewed by experts in the field before publication. And finally, after about a year or so, we begin to see the first few books written about the event. This format of information, while typically more comprehensive, takes longer to produce because books go through many editorial steps. We can usually find clues about which of these resources we need to find by looking at our assignment instructions. By knowing what types of information we need to find, we can identify where to start looking for information. Google lends itself best to finding social media, news, and blogs. Search engines like the Library Quick Search or subject-specific databases from the library lend themselves best to finding news, magazines, scholarly and peer-reviewed journal articles, and books. Take a moment and think about what types of resources you want to find around oil spills and ocean life. If it's scholarly and peer-reviewed journal articles, magazines, news articles, and books, then you should start using the Library Quick Search.